Yesterday at 7:53 p.m. local time, about 13 minutes before sunset, the ground began to rapidly shake back and forth southeast of the major city of Balikesir in Turkey, causing people to panic. A strong earthquake had just struck around 40 kilometers southeast of the aforementioned city, registering in as a magnitude 6.1. Across the next 7 seconds, items fell off of shelves, furniture was thrown around, chimneys collapsed, and in select cases, entire structures, especially some of those made of unreinforced brick, completely collapsed. The simulation you are seeing in the background shows the reported peak intensity shaking the earthquake produced, specifically MMI-8 intensity shaking within the town of Kakheli. This killed at least one person and caused approximately 24 structures to completely collapse. While the U.S. Geological Survey model estimates can be quite wrong, they are estimating a 50% chance of the earthquake having caused between 4 and 60 fatalities and between $21 million and $469 million U.S. dollars in damage. For now, I am leaning towards the very bottom of the middle 50% range, perhaps slightly lower than this in each instance based on the damage I have seen posted on social media. While I have found no conclusive proof of such, models also suggested a high likelihood of limited landslides in some more rugged areas and some liquefaction having occurred in more alluvial areas filled with sediment having happened. This earthquake's damage, while affecting far fewer people than a similar magnitude 6.2 earthquake in Turkey during April, seemingly caused more severe damage for a few reasons. 1. The earthquake occurred at shallower depths, with various sources estimating an epicenter between half a kilometer and 10 kilometers below ground. 2. The closest population center from yesterday's quake experienced stronger shaking than from the April quake, which was centered in the Sea of Marmara. 3. The latest earthquake occurred in an area where many settlements were built on top of or adjacent to alluvial sediments, something which, as the simulation shows, naturally amplifies the intensity of seismic waves compared to harder bedrock units such as granite. And 4. In this region of Turkey, while I could be wrong, it appears to me that more structures are built out of unreinforced concrete and brick than in Istanbul proper. Such unreinforced structures of concrete and brick are far more susceptible to earthquake damage than buildings that are reinforced or constructed with other building materials such as wood can bend slightly to absorb some of the seismic waves. However, I want to note something interesting about yesterday's strong earthquake. It occurred on a known but presumably somewhat buried normal fault that strikes west-northwest. That isn't the weird part. The weird part is that it appears that almost the entirety of this lesser-known seemingly unnamed fault line ruptured during the earthquake, meaning this quake was probably the single largest event it could theoretically produce. However, because this earthquake released some regional strain in an overall extensional environment that exists in this section of Turkey, it put some of this strain onto a much longer fault line, theoretically capable of larger magnitude earthquakes. Already, this other fault line has experienced a magnitude 4.2 quake as an aftershock, specifically 22 minutes after the main quake. Now, I am absolutely not suggesting that this larger fault has a likelihood of producing a damaging aftershock soon. I am just mentioning it to explain why an aftershock occurred on it. Theoretically speaking, the largest aftershock is most likely to be around a magnitude 4.9, but this is not a certainty. More aftershocks are likely to strike in the upcoming days, but few, if any of these, are statistically likely to be damaging, with a decreasing rate of aftershocks day over day. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting my work.